Hey everyone, Surreal Canine here. Welcome back for the Fuka and Deska show. In the last episode, we beat the boss of the Mint. Now we're going to go see what's up. So yeah. Actually, let's heal first and then we'll go see what's up. Unopening safe.
This is the Mint safe? It looks really sturdy for some reason. A normal demon couldn't bust through this.
Good thing we brought a thief.
Not even you would have been able to break into this kind of safe on your own, Artina. Aren't you glad we teamed up? No, if I could have done my usual recon, a safe like this wouldn't have been a problem. It would have been a piece of cake. Piece of cake, huh? Your personality really changes when it comes to money. It's what I like about you. Anyway, we've basically got the Jillian Hill. My nightmare will be over soon, and my awesome wish is about to come true. Oh, I can't wait! You're contradicting yourself, Fuka. This is all a dream, but you still want your wish to come true when you reincarnate?
Contradicting? Yes, Artina is right. If Big Sis's wish will come true, then Deska should be happy, because she's Big Sis's little sister.
Deska, are you sure you're okay? If you can't talk to Fuka about it, you can come to me anytime.
Hey, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, hi, Emizel.
Emizel, what are you doing here?
I heard that three Jokers were invading the Mint. I got a little worried, so I came to check things out. And what do you know? It's the three of you. What are you thinking?
Three Jokers? You're including me with that?
Do you know what you've gotten yourselves into? The Mint is one of the most important facilities in the Netherworld! Do you think you can really get away with doing something like this?
Depends on if you've been level grinding to keep up with us, Emizel.
For saving its ass. I seem to remember constantly hearing the phrase, bringing it under our control.
Collect what the Netherworld owes you? What are you talking about? What you're doing is plain stealing! The Netherworld is just starting to get back on its feet after what Nemo did! Even if President Axe will let you act on your selfish reasoning, I won't!
I can't believe I'm letting a demon talk sense into me! Get a hold of yourself, Artina! We have good reasons! Justice, our beliefs, our mission!
How can you justify what you're doing? And shut up about your sleep talk!
I don't have time to explain it to you! For our justice and beliefs! And for my Jillian Hill! Come on, Deska! Artina! Final formation! We are Tri-Angels!
You guys just kind of left Artina out of the whole thing. Alright, level 1600 Emizel. And he's got some magic change weapons on him. Simple enough, I guess. But,
Let me show you!
Not the best use of our geo properties, but
ready for me?
Who cares? Let's get some chests. Measel can wait. See, Pretty Barrage got an upgrade a little bit. Bad in the idiot department yourself, Ika.
At least this hellish nightmare is almost over. With a jillion hell, only a rosy, happy life is waiting for me when I wake up.
Really? What are you talking about? You're starting to scare me.
I know what you mean, but that's still a little harsh to say to a girl.
Tina is right. It's not scary. It's supposed to be happy. Because finally, Big Sis's dream will... Her dream to dominate the world will... Dusko needs to be happy. Big Sis's dream is coming true.
What's the matter, Dusko? Why are you crying? Did a measle touch you in your no-no area?
The hell I would!
I'm sorry. When Dusko thought about Big Sis's dream of dominating the world coming true, her chest got tighter and tighter. Her tears were...
Huh? Hold on. Whose dream is world domination? I didn't say that was the wish I was gonna make.
What? But your dream is to dominate the world. That's why Dusko was created.
Exactly. Dominating the world is your job.
So, Dusko is allowed to make Big Sis's dream come true?
Of course! I'm looking forward to it, so you better get on it as a final boss!
Big Sis! Thank you very much! Dusko will do her best to fulfill Big Sis's dream of world domination!
I get it, okay? Now, stop crying. You're so silly, Desko. You're the only one who can make my dream of dominating the world come true. I don't agree with the idea of world domination, but that was very heartwarming.
It was.
So what is this all about anyway? I don't get it.
I'm gonna pay off my sins with the Jillion Hell that I'm gonna get.
A Jillion Hell? What the? That's ridiculous!
I'll give you some of it, so can you make my wish come true? I know all about the rumor where one wish will come true when I reincarnate if I bribe death.
I don't even know where to start!
Big Sis? What is your wish anyway? Desko really wants to know.
Oh, there's so many! Be the cutest model in the universe, be the most popular girl in the universe, and there are a bunch more sweet and cute dreams that I want to accomplish, even more than dominating the world.
More than dominating the world? Desko is a little sad to hear that.
You've got it all wrong. Even if you pay off your sins, you're not going to reincarnate as yourself, you know.
What?
The ninth grader, Fuka Kazumatsuri, is dead. You're not gonna revive. You're gonna reincarnate and be reborn as someone else.
Reborn? What do you mean? What are you talking about?
So if Big Sis pays off her sins and reincarnates, she's not gonna be Big Sis anymore?
Correct. The person named Fuka will be gone. She will reincarnate into the human world and start a new life as a new person.
Life? What about the 14 years that I lived? All of my memories, my heart, and my mind?
They'll all be gone. Poof, just like that. That's what reincarnating is. That's what purifying your soul means.
Are you serious? What the? This is ridiculous! Nobody told me that!
Everything? Gone? Including Desko? What about Desko? She's gonna forget all about Desko?
Buffeted by this unbearable truth, just like a rubber ducky that is tossed around by a stormy ocean.
Desko can't believe Big Sis will forget all about her!
Desko's heart, too, sways like a girl riding the bus, sitting on the seat right above the wheel, getting car sick.
Oh, how tragic!
Then a beautiful man appears like the wind. He's a vampire who only drinks sardine blood due to a mysterious incurable disease.
Here! This sardine will help you through your pain!
Oh, Sir Valvatores!
The gust eventually brings the storm and rattles the two girls' hearts. What will become of Fuka and Desko? Look forward to next time on Netherworld Romance, Crimson Sisterhood, Episode 2, Beautiful Vampire.
Big Sis, my tears won't stop!
What's wrong with you guys?
That's what I want to know, Amiezel. That's what I want to know.
Fuka, an unfortunate girl whose soul was sent to Hades after she met with misfortune, is in complete denial about her death. Souls sent to Hades must earn enough hell in the netherworld to pay off their sins in order for them to receive purification. Fuka obtained a Jillion Hell by invading the Netherworld Mint in the hopes of waking up from her dream. However, Fuka is struck with an unbelievable truth before her purification ceremony. The purification of her soul will reset her memories of her past life, and she will reincarnate as a brand new human. As Fuka stands in confusion, another individual is also muddled by this truth. That person is...
Desko doesn't want Big Sis to forget about her! No way! Desko couldn't bear that!
It doesn't seem like she's gonna stop crying anytime soon. At this rate, the Netherworld will be flooded with her tears! You're her Big Sis, can't you do something? Isn't she supposed to follow your orders? Tell her to stop already!
It wouldn't matter, Emizel. A mere order can't stop a lady's tears. But you might be able to help.
Me? How? What do you want me to do?
You're the only son of our former president. Can't you just make up a new rule, like my soul will just revive back into my body?
I'm pretty sure this is some grand order of the cosmos.
I know you can! I mean, just do it!
That's impossible! This isn't a rule! It's how the world works! No one can do anything about it!
Never give up, Emizel. Just because someone made up some stupid rule, my whole life is gonna be reset! I haven't even lived my life long enough to just give it all up and start over! Hit continue.
That's nonsense. Don't you think this is all just a dream anyway? So who cares whether it's reset or continue?
Desko does! No matter what the reason is, Desko won't allow anyone to erase Big Sis's memory to reincarnate her. Big Sis demands to wake up from this dream by reviving without erasing her memories.
Yeah, I mean, you could just go to Prinnyland and stay there forever.
The Netherworld Savior, Big Sis, even collected a jillion hell! Make it happen! The reset! Soul, please! Continue, Soul! Save Big Sis's memory!
Desko, I know this is hard for you, but Fuka can't just stay here like this without ever reincarnating.
Nonsense! Human souls that are sent to Hades must pay off their sins as prinnies and reincarnate to get a fresh start with a new human life. That is the rule! As a prinny instructor, I won't let any prinny violate this rule!
Belzy! Don't you care if Big Sis will lose all of her memories? Don't you care if Big Sis forgets all about you?
Nope, not at all. Actually, I wish I could erase all of the useless memories of you guys from my lord's mind.
Don't bring Desko into this, Fenric. That's just rude. Desko hasn't done anything wrong.
What's your problem? You're making me not want to reincarnate even more.
As long as you're a prinny, I forbid you from thinking outside the prinny box. I must re-educate you.
What a fantastic idea, my lord. After all, she never even learned to include the word do in every line she says. Let's take this opportunity to make her understand her position as a prinny. We shall pound it into her skull over and over.
Re-educate? I remember you saying something about that before. Hey. I don't know about other prinnies, but do you really think that you can handle re-educating me, Bowsy?
Need I even answer such a foolish question?
Okay then, it's a challenge. If you can re-educate me, I'll reincarnate however many times you want me to.
It's a deal. Now I can finally get rid of you.
You haven't won yet. If you fail, though, you know what's gonna happen, right?
Yes, yes, I'll approve of you acting freely as Fuka Kazamatsuri, and not as a prinny. Revive, continue, or keep enjoying your life in the Netherworld, or whatever else you wish to do.
Do you promise? A promise is absolute!
Of course I promise! However, my re-education is also absolute! It shall not fail!
Contest is on!
My prinny rehabilitation program has a 120% success rate. Zetai Prinny Project! Prepare yourself!
re-educate me, you'll regret you ever thought that you could re-educate me.
I think you're gonna be the one who ends up regretting this. Not a single Prinny has ever escaped Valvatorez' deadly rehab course, the Zetai Prinny Project. You can't back out now, so just give up. I'll be looking forward to seeing your selfish personality gradually become obedient.
Me too, Weasel. Less we have to deal with idiot Fuka, the better.
As a member of the big sis bodyguards, you will be helping her out!
What? Why me?
Yeah, why him?
Why not? Right, Desko?
Yes, big sis.
Now, everyone, as the noble big sis bodyguards, we must show them our true power! United as one, we will put a stop to big sis' re-education!
By any chance, am I included in that bodyguard team?
Of course! We will unite as one, say no to re-education!
Okay.
Desko can't hear you! Put your hearts into it!
Okay.
Ready? Always for Big Sis!
Okay. We got Umizel back. You got the pirate ship Lady Fuka. Okay. Let's go check out the new pirate ship, I guess. That still looks ridiculous. Oops. Well, that just looks absolutely ridiculous, but, yeah. I guess the sooner we get through this and forget this ever happened, the better. yeah. See you guys next time!